Hey, my name is Gala. I'm a Google Data Studio expert, and today we talk about filter by email. I already prepared two tables in Google Sheets. The first table, it is sales. In this table, we have date. We have different channel traffic, sales and revenue. And let's imagine that I want to prepare one report with sales information, and I want to provide different accesses for different managers. For example, SEO manager should have access only for organic traffic, and paid traffic manager should have access only for paid traffic sales. For this, I created another tab with filter. I added here all channels that we have here in the table, and I added email column here and added my Gmail with what I work from. I added it to in front of data sources that I want to have access. Let's connect this Google document to Google Data Studio. Resources, manage edit data sources, add Google Sheets. We add now for start, we will add sales table. Sorry for delay. Yeah, sometimes it happens. Okay, add to report. Let's create a table with our data. We have some troubles. Let me check. Why do I have this trouble? Sales channel. What is wrong here? I really don't understand what is going wrong. Yeah, it is numbers. Date numbers, so should be fine. Cannot connect to a data source. Let's reconnect it. I don't know. Channel date, number, finish. It's some bug here. Okay. Yeah, you can see sometimes happens like weird stuff. We just can reconnect, reload everything, and sometimes it works. Okay, let's see channel, sales and revenue. I would like to see revenue in dollars, for example. Revenue change to US dollar. Nice. So we have a table with all channels, and like we have 12 channels, and and for example, I want to see the same on this chart, on the bar chart. I will just do like this, and we want to see only revenue, for example, sort by revenue, and okay. So this is our chart. And now we want to have access only for part of this data, only for organic traffic. Next step, I connect our second table with email accesses, add data, Google Sheets. Now I add this filter tab. Add to report. Okay, nice. And let's go to resources, manage added data sources. And here we have this, our filter table. Here, interesting moment. We have filter by email. Click here, filter data by email, and select field that contains emails. And finish. After that, we should create blend. Click here, blend data, and we should join our main sales table with the filter table. It should be like filter table should be left. We have channel emails and configure join by left outer join by channel. Filtered SEO. Let's check what do we have here. So I blended data from email table, from this table and sales table. Okay, email field I don't need it here. As you see, we had 12 rows when we created this blend. We have only rows. We have only rows where I edit my email. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here we have only 6 rows. And we want to apply this filter to this tab as well. We already created blend, so we just change data sources to the blend. See, we have only 6 rows where I do have access. If we remove something, for example, like refer or direct traffic, I want to remove access to direct traffic. I can delete my email from here and update the page. Oh, I think no. I should to update the data. Update here. Refresh the data. I click the 3 dots and refresh the data. And you see, we have 5 rows now. That is it. And a really important moment about this blend. Your data source, your table with emails should be on the left side of the blend. It is super important. If you move the right side, it will not work. So this is a small trick, and that is it. I hope it is clear and you will use it in your practice. Enjoy.